You're still watching New Vision TV News with me, Ruth Inaseje. Now let's take a look at what is making headlines in the business industry with Lynn Komjishe.
Today in business, New Vision TV and Vision Group platforms will dig into and analyze all the budget speeches since 1986. The 1986-87 financial year budget was the first budget tabled by the National Resistance Movement government presented after taking over power. Totaling 1.1 trillion shillings, the budget was 40 times smaller than the 40 trillion Uganda shillings 2019-2020 budget. Paul Busharizi will be carrying out a comparative analysis of the budgets over the years every day on New Vision TV. The analysis will show the country's economic performance over the years through the budget. By 1986, the country was exporting $380 million worth of goods and services. Now exports have grown to $6.2 billion worth of goods and services. The budget series will climax with Vision Group's Chief Executive Officer's budget panel discussion on Budget Day. The New Vision newspaper and online will also publish the budget series beginning tomorrow. Now finally, users of the Entebbe Express are to pay for using it after Uganda National Roads Authority announced it had set up a committee to set the fees. The road opened last year, no toll has been levied, raising concern of the loss of planned revenue to pay back the loan taken to construct it. In November 2010, the government of Uganda and China signed an agreement where the Chinese government, through the Exim Bank of China, would lend up to $350 million, which is about 1.3 trillion Uganda shillings, for the construction of the highway, payable over a period of 40 years. UNRWA will select a company to operate the toll plazas, whose duty will include maintaining and cleaning the road. Road tolls have been introduced as an off-budget source of financing for road infrastructure development projects. Cabinet has approved the creation of 9 cities, 5 of which will become operational on July 1, 2020. These cities include Arua, Gulu, Jinja, Fort Portal, and Barara, which will be elevated from municipal status. The others are Hoima and Mbale, which will become operational on July 1, 2021. And according to the Minister of Local Government, Tom Butime, the cabinet meeting resolved that the municipalities will be elevated in a phased manner. A budget of 130 billion Uganda shillings is to be set aside for the operations of the cities after meeting all the requirements. Edna Mubiru, the business editor here at the New Vision newspaper, joins us to make plain why the country needs new cities.
My name is Lynn. I have with me Edna Ruth Mubiru. Edna, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Lynn.
Edna, the cabinet has approved 9 new cities. Recently, we saw Parliament complain that they don't have enough money for new districts, but now they're approving cities within these particular districts, or these different districts. And they start operation, some of them, by July next year. Kampala won't be, of course, the only city. My worry is, what has changed? They were saying they don't have enough money for new districts, but now they have money for new divisions within the districts. Does that make sense?
I think that the concern with the new districts was that you're creating a whole administrative structure, you know.
Yes.
And you're probably cutting it off from some area that already has the structure, so you're replicating. But what they're doing for the new cities is combining areas that are already in existence, that already have these structures, and bringing them together and saying this is a city, and these are the upgrades that we need to do for it to get to city status.
Well, that makes a lot of sense, but do they have the money, the administration costs, and ABCD?
By the time they are saying that, by the time they give you city status, you have shown signs that you can generate revenue that can take care of your costs.
Right.
So if you look at some of the areas, you see Gulu, you've seen Mbarara, Hoima, these are areas that have shown potential, you know, and they are already growing into hubs of some sorts, their business hubs. So the hope probably is that because they are already doing this, they should be able to generate a lot more income to take care of their own costs without depending on the central government.
Thank you, Edna.
Thank you, Lynn.
Thank you, Lynn. In our daily Pearl of Africa series, we look at Chisizi Falls. There is no place in Uganda that has gained much popularity because of its history like Chisizi Falls. What makes Chisizi unique for tourists is how the ancient site associated with death turned out to be a place of hope. The falls attract tourists from across the globe. Let's take a look.
The beautiful Chisizi Falls lies on Chabamba River, a few meters from Chisizi Hospital in Rukungiri District, which borders with Kabale, the Switzerland of Uganda. In the southwestern corner of Uganda, these 30-meter-high falls meander through a valley of green vegetation leading to Lake Edward. This explains the rapid sounds of water that can nearly block your ears while here. But if you decide to calm yourself, then welcome the reception of this sound. All you hear are music melodies. The sound that hits and bounces off the rocks is accompanied by strong winds through the trees and the singing birds. The history that looms around these falls is clearly shown on these sculptures. A quick stare at them defines what tradition would offer if you did not add air to it. Traditionally, the Chiga girls who would get pregnant before marriage would be thrown down to meet their fate from this cliff. The practice was followed for a long time till when the tables turned. This happened to a family which lost two children at the same time to the falls. It was the role of a brother to push his pregnant sister down the falls as family and community members looked on. That fateful day, as a girl was dragged to the cliff, she pulled her brother and two fell to the bottom of the falls and died. It is reported that since then the Bachiga abandoned the practice. But like many African cultures, premarital pregnancies were prohibited. For the Bachiga, dropping culprits from Chisizi Falls was the verdict. Such tales make the visit to the place worthwhile since they are told in a traditional setting. Some of the people who witnessed such actions are still alive. After exploring these notable features at Chisizi, there are more activities you cannot miss out on. A small forest surrounding the falls is a great place for picnics, hikes, and forest walks. To attain a great view of the Chigezi area involving yourself in hikes is very commendable. It also feels good walking on the bridge for those who don't fear heights. This is definitely what you need. Ziplining is just another interesting activity that can be tried out. Chisizi Hospital is also greatly connected to the falls. When the practice of dumping unmarried pregnant girls into the falls stopped, the area became a place of hope and healing. The Church of Uganda established Chisizi Hospital in 1958. The hospital now attends to over 300 patients who come for health services on a daily basis. Features like Chisizi Falls are the reason why Uganda is called the Pearl of Africa. With such adventures, staying in this country gets better day by day.
Now, for more Pearl of Africa stories, visit our website, which is newvision.co.eug/Pearl of Africa. Our newspaper, The Sunday Vision, is also another home of adventures. Grab your copy every Sunday for Pearl of Africa series. We end the bulletin with a special report. Now, the zeal and determination to be among Uganda's top passion fruit farmers triggers the Sena brothers' ambition to add value to their produce. These passion fruit farmers don't stop at selling the fruit, but also engage in selling the juice. Let's take a look.
Sena brothers, Godfrey Sebunya Sava and Paul Mukasa Sebunya, sons of Edward Sebunya, share their story on how they acquired a fortune from selling passion fruits.
Gereke bilizali za mzee wafe, na tuwa netulimirako, netulabanga business yobu tunda simbi, echomu kisomulunji wanubali batundao. Netujia netugula wane mto wange, netutaandika.
Currently they harvest at least 100 sacks of passion fruit a month, making about Uganda shilling 65 million.
Kati buli omu ali ku target yawo alubirira kukola ki kutuukiriza ekyo naye nga projection ya nsawa 2-2.5.
Godfrey, who had traveled to Australia and stayed there for 1 year, had realized that farmers in Australia were making a lot of money and were highly respected. He then made a decision to start agriculture.
Nali musajja nkuba kyeyo kati ntambuddeko mu nsi nnyingi naye ne ndabanga abalimi be basinga obugagga mu nsi ezaakulaakulana osanga abalimi be balina ssente. Kakati mwaka gw'2014 muto wange yamaliriza okusoma amawulire ne nkoma awaka ne mugamba kati omanyi togenda kunoonya mulimu, tusooke tugezeeko ennimiro okulima obutunda tulabe bwe kinaatambula. Kakati ne tugamba omanyi tugenda kukwata edduuka limu likole ennimiro ki twatandika nayo.
The brothers visited a number of farms and attended various trainings. After a lot of thinking and comparisons, they decided to grow passion fruit. The agribusiness company faced several challenges ranging from price fluctuations, fake drugs on the market, long drought, and inconsistent prices.
Twakola ensobi twasimba obutunda, twasima ebinnya binene ne muto wange oyo ennimiro eri enkadde. Kakati bwe tusima ebinnya binene ne tusimba obutunda mu kinnya nga tetuzizzaako ttaka okusooka, kati nga bw'oyimirira wano bw'oti obutunda tobulaba olengera binnya byereere. Ate sizoni yali ya musana obutunda ne butandika okukala, kati ne tuyita omwami alina akalimiro k'obutunda awo ku kyalo najja n'atugamba, bannaye mukozese ku magezi amazaali. Ne twetunuulira bwetu tetwegamba na kigambo, ne tusimbuliza obutunda bwonna abantu babiri paka sawa nga bi ne katooki nga bonna netubusimbuza nga tuzaamu ettaka ne tukakola ki ne tukikola mu ngeri entuufu. Kati eyo experience buli wenzijjukira bwe tula ku kifaananyi ekyo nsega ekyo kifaananyi kisinga amakulu.
The farm is located in Nabiyaki, Chiyunga, Mukono. However, the two brothers were determined to make the business work.
Obulumi tulina buyita mwaba ne muzeeyi waffe ali supportive nnyo nga bw'okiwulira. Era nga tusulana mu tenti, tenti eri wali muti mbwa zaagiruma, twasula mu tenti omwaka mulamba kulandira nga kugamba ebintu byaffe byonna byali nga bw'ogiwabye ddala nti abantu tebamanyi kye bakola ki, naye ne twekkiririzaamu twagamba kino tulina okkikola tulina okkimala.
They opted to technologically advance the venture. Soon the duo started making more profits from the farm after selling the passion fruits. This encouraged them to expand the garden and develop more income generating ideas from selling passion fruits.
Jezo, twagala nnyo okudizera abavubuka, twagala nnyo okuinspiringa abavubuka. Era ekyo bwe tunaakikola, tujja kuba happy. Yemu ku goals.
Their business spread in 7 branches in Wantoni, Mukono and Seta Town. It also now occupies 9 acres of land and has 5 permanent workers with a number of casual workers. The brothers now hope to start an ice cream and yogurt venture with the passion fruit flavor.
Twamala dokola recipe ya ice cream wa obutunda tujirina tugenda tandika tulinda musana era kati tutandika okugula machines za ice cream tugendera nga tukola branches ne tujja sookera waffe wali electronics tusooke tulabe business yo bw'ekola ki bw'etandika. Naye tulina eyo plan yakola ice cream sena ice cream kusinga ng'ava mu butunda, recipe ya jam ow'emigaati nayo tugirina tugiyina era tugenda tutandika nayo gikolako naye lwakuba ebintu bigenda mpola mpola.
They have already secured the recipes and are now in the process of procuring machines.
Ekyatandisa value addition eri sente zaali ziva mu butunda first of all. Ekyokubiri obutunda ffe tetutunda butunda kefunyiza, buli muntu ajja wano mu challenginga Lona katunda ko nako sanze kutaka bosanga mwaka kalunga te kali mu juice. Echo chizibu nyo.
For more on this special report, visit our website, which is newvision.co.eug/video. You can also follow us on social media. Facebook is The New Vision. Twitter is @NewVisionWire. Instagram is @NewVisionWire. And our YouTube channel is New Vision TV. Catch up with me on my Twitter handle. I am Ruthie The Voice. We end with a fact file.